Who is this video for? If you want to take care of your curly hair, but you don't want to follow CGM because of budget reasons, because in India curly hair products are really expensive, then this video is for you. Today we're going to be talking about the brand called Enliven. This is a brand from the UK and all of their products are pretty large. You'll see that their shampoo and conditioner comes in a 400 ml bottle. Their mousse comes in a 300 ml bottle and their gel comes in a 500 ml bottle, and all of these products retail for under 300 rupees. So basically this is a budget brand that's made in the UK, and today we're going to be reviewing them. So this video pretty much came about because some of you said that you don't want to follow CG because of budget reasons, and so you don't mind using brands or using products that are questionable when it comes to CG as long as you can use them for your curly hair. And before people who are hardcore CG followers freak out, let me just direct your attention to this. Mains by Mel is the biggest curly hair creator on YouTube, and she does not follow CG. She also has a fantastic video on why she doesn't follow the curly girl method, and I'll leave that video linked down below. Please have a look at that. So if you're a CG follower, then essentially you're boycotting four things: sulfates, silicones, parabens, and drying alcohols. And if you're a CG consumer, then instead of using sulfates, you use surfactants. Instead of using silicones, we use oils. And when it comes to parabens, so parabens are essentially preservatives. And all of your curly hair products, if you're a CG consumer, definitely do have preservatives in them. They might not be parabens, but you still have preservatives in your curly hair products. And when it comes to alcohol, so you have two types. You have drying alcohols and you have fatty alcohols. If you're a CG consumer, then you'll see that all of your products do have fatty alcohols. However, they don't have drying alcohols. Now, when it comes to me, I follow a modified version of CG, which means to say that when it comes to sulfates, I'm okay using sulfates when I'm doing a clarifying wash, and I'm okay using alcohol, but in moderation. Which means that whenever I use an alcohol, I make sure I overcompensate and over moisturize so that my hair doesn't dry out. When it comes to parabens, I'm still okay because I feel like I'd rather have a preservative in my hair products, because that is only going to enhance or increase the shelf life of the products, and it's not going to allow bacterial growth in the products itself. So I'm okay with that too. However, when it comes to silicones, this is the deal. Silicones are basically ingredients that create a barrier over the hair, and they give you great shine and great slip. Silicones are non-toxic, but they're always compared to plastic or rubber that coats the hair. However, silicones are also used in food, which means that they're completely non-toxic and are edible grade as well. Silicones are also great for heat protection because it forms a barrier over the hair and it really protects against heat styling. So if you're going in between wearing your hair curly and wearing your hair straight, then silicones might be a great addition to your routine. Now, when it comes to silicones, you have water-soluble silicones and you have non-water-soluble silicones. One will dissolve with water and one will not. Non-water-soluble silicones do not wash off with water, and typically you need a sulfate to get rid of the silicone. Now, non-water-soluble silicones can build up on the hair, especially if you have curly hair. And to get rid of the silicone, it takes a minimum of 8 washes. And so my advice to you is this. So basically, you have to decide if you're okay with silicones or if you're not okay with silicones. Because essentially, if you're okay with silicones and you're going to use them, then you definitely need a sulfate every single wash. However, if you go in between being silicone free and using silicone, then it's going to be really difficult because that silicone is just going to build up on your hair. Therefore, my honest advice to you would be to pick a lane and stick to it. So basically, silicones seal the hair and protect it from moisture loss. If you decide to use silicones, then you have to use a sulfate because that is the only way to remove the silicone in the first place. Also note that it can take a minimum of 8 washes to completely remove silicone buildup in the first place. Now, let me explain things a little better. Imagine that this is the surface of your hair. and you've just started CGM. There is a very, very good chance that you have silicone buildup on your hair from previous washes. It is going to take you 8 clarifying washes to remove that silicone buildup that is on your hair. This is basically why curly hair transitions happen. Well, it's a mixture of removing that silicone and also girl training. However, having that silicone on your hair is a very big part of why your hair looks dull when you start CGM. Now, if you're applying products on top of silicone buildup, remember that the silicone is a protective barrier and it doesn't allow anything to enter or exit the hair. So your hair is basically blocked from the residual silicone that you have used before you started CGM. And so the products that you start applying once you start CGM will have a difficult time penetrating that silicone barrier. And this is why your hair looks dull initially. Now with time, the silicone buildup gets removed. Your hair is now able to absorb product. Curl training also happens and then your curly transition is complete. You start noticing that your hair has more shine, more bounce, more elasticity, more shrinkage and better looking curls in general. Now, what happens if you decide not to take up CGM? You're not boycotting any ingredients, which means that you use sulfates to clean your hair and then you use silicones to create a protective barrier. And this is not all bad because having silicone on your hair is a great protectant against heat and other environmental forces. But you have to remember that this should happen in a loop, which means that if you use silicones, you should definitely use sulfates every single time you wash your hair. If you're doing CGM or if you're following CGM, then technically you shouldn't use silicones. However, you can use sulfates every time you clarify your hair. So every time you notice that there's a lot of buildup of oils and products on your hair, then you can clarify using a sulfate. Now look, very honestly, there is nothing wrong with either philosophy, but my advice here is to decide if you're going to use silicones or if you're going to boycott silicones. Pick a lane and then stick to it. Alright, so now let's talk about their products one by one. First is their shampoo. This is their raspberry and red apple shampoo. It comes in a 400 ml bottle and this retails for 299 rupees. The shampoo contains sulfates and it does contain silicone. And let me tell you a little bit about how this performed on my hair. I felt like this was very cleansing and it was pretty stripping as well. Let's talk about the performance of the shampoo. I felt like the shampoo lathered up insanely. I felt like it was very cleansing and it was also very, very stripping. And so I feel like if you're using this shampoo, then definitely pre-poo and pre-poo the lengths of your hair so that your hair doesn't dry out during the shampoo process. And you guys will notice that when I pre-poo my hair, I only pre-poo my scalp. However, if you're going in with this shampoo, then you definitely do not want it to strip your hair so much. And so I would say, please pre-poo your lengths so that the shampoo doesn't dry out your lengths too much. So this shampoo is not CG friendly. It contains sulfates, silicones, and parabens. And I use 10 grams to shampoo my hair. So the next product is the conditioner. This is the raspberry and red apple conditioner. This comes in a 400 ml bottle and retails for 299 rupees. Okay, I'm so sorry. You'll have to deal with the noise because my neighbor switched on the AC and it's making a racket. Does this make it better? All right, so I'm gonna record this part and if it doesn't turn out well, then I'll just voice over this entire section. So the conditioner, I was pretty taken aback by the slip and granted I used a lot of conditioner but man oh man the slip was really nice and I was quite surprised by it. Now the conditioner does not have sulfates, does not have silicones, it does have parabens. And so if you're okay with it then you can use it as a leave-in conditioner. Now is it okay to use a normal conditioner as leave-in conditioner? I have a dedicated video on this topic and I'm gonna leave it linked down below, so check that out once you're done with this video. Alright, so to detangle, I used 15 grams of conditioner and as leave-in, I used 10 grams of conditioner. Next up is the mousse. This is the Enliven Ultra Hold Mousse. and it comes in a 300 ml bottle and I paid 299 rupees for it. The hold is fairly decent. I've used it as a single styler in a video before. I'll also leave that video down in the description. The mousse does not contain sulfates, does not contain silicones. It does contain parabens. And one little tip that I want to give you guys is when you're styling your hair, we keep talking about that seaweed-like feeling, right? However, when you're using the mousse, my advice would be to go in with a little dry hair, which means that if you style on damp hair, let it dry a tiny bit. You want your hair to be a little drier than that, because once you use the mousse, you'll notice that your hair gets really wet. And so that seaweed-like feeling might not happen for you. And then your hair might get too damp, way too damp for you to style on. And when that happens, you'll notice that you'll end up using more product, right? Because you won't have that gloopy, gloppy, seaweed-like feeling in your hair. So my recommendation would be to start off with a little less water in your hair when you're styling with the mousse. The mousse has fairly decent hold. I've used it as a single styler in one of my videos and I'm gonna leave that video down in the description. All right, next is the gel. This is the 500 ml tub and it also comes in a 250 ml tub. The 250 ml tub is 149 rupees and this is 240 rupees. For 500 ml. Typically when I style my hair, I use 20 grams of gel, but only because my hair needs a lot of hold. The Enliven gels come in so many different variants and essentially the difference between the gels would be of the level of hold that you get. So the red tub is a level 3 hold, the blue and the orange tubs are a level 4 hold, and the green tub that I use today is a level 5 hold. So the difference in these numbers would be the difference in the amount of hold that the product gives you. Now, let's talk about some of the ingredients in the gel that are considered to be problematic. Number one, it has a drying alcohol, which means that this could potentially dry out your hair. So my advice when using these gels would be to definitely deep condition your hair with a heavy deep conditioning hair mask. And secondly, when you're scrunching out the crunch, definitely use a light oil or a serum to protect against that dryness. Now, the gel has an ingredient called DMDM Hydantoin, which is a formaldehyde releaser. And Tresemme came under some hot water because of this ingredient, and there was also a lawsuit. I urge you to read up on it. Now, does this mean that this ingredient is problematic and it could harm your hair? Dr. Dre has a fabulous video on DMDM Hydantoin where she details everything that you need to know about the ingredient. Essentially, I'm gonna link her video down below, but essentially what she says in the video is that there is always a possibility that a small percentage of the population could at some point develop an allergic reaction to this ingredient. That being said, is this the only product where we see this ingredient in? No, the Curl Up Leave-In Conditioner also has DMDM Hydantoin. But we are educated consumers now and it's very important for us to understand that most of our hair products have one or two ingredients that could be considered to be problematic, that could cause an allergic reaction. Does that mean that everyone is going to have an allergic reaction to the ingredients? No. But there is always a chance that a small percentage of the population could at some point develop an allergic reaction to a particular ingredient. Now, I'm also going to leave a list of all the possible or potential allergens commonly found in hair products right here, and I'd request you to screenshot this section and tally it with your existing products. I'm sure you'll notice that most of your products have one or two of these ingredients. Was I a little scared about doing this video and trying out these products? Yes, because I typically don't use silicones. And guys, let me just tell you that this is the first time in 15 months that I have used a silicone in my hair. So if you want to know about my progress and what's going on with my hair right now and you're watching this video in the future, then check out the description because I'll update you guys there. So if you enjoyed this video, then there's a very good chance that you might enjoy one of these. And go through my channel. I have so much content that you can watch if you're interested in hair care.